Hello, everybody. Hello, Teresa. I wish you can catch up on live video. If not, we'll record it. So let me record it also on Zoom. I'm going to send. Okay, this is a video showing the design and carving process of Chinese name seal for artist Teresa Gautier. Gautier. I don't know how to pronounce it correctly, but let me write the name in Chinese. And this is how we got this translation, if you will. There's no actually exact translation of English name in Chinese because there's completely different system of language. So in Chinese, the family name only have about 100. As in West, you have very unique family names, but very common first names. This lady last name is quite unique. So we translated. If you put on Google, it will give you a phonetic translation, which starts with this character. That's what we adopted. Gao. That's pronounced from this first syllable. Means hi. This is a. It happened to be a common Chinese surname, a family name. So we adopt that. Then we, I think on Google it has a Gao Di. Yeah, something like that. Just a pronunciation that has no meaning actually. But we made it more personal with the same pronunciation of the D, this syllable. We use the character for fruit. Fruit, the blowing instrument, music instrument, because Teresa like music, so we will use something related to music. It's made of bamboo, right? With this same sound radical as in this one. And the last part of it, we change it into ya. Ya means elegant taste, or I don't know how to translate it. It's an aesthetic value in Chinese art versus vulgar. Ya means elegant. Okay, so high taste, or high fruit, tasteful, elegance, or elegant taste. Okay, D. Yeah, that's the pronunciation of it. Now we are going to write in different script. Okay, so this is almost like the print. Let me write it more clearly. This part actually could be more standardized. They put this. It's optional. You put either this, like two bars with two dashes, or you put a square. That's either way will work. Many people like to do this way, the two bars, because you see why this repeat itself. That this one create a little variation. D, this is the bamboo, this is the phonetic pronunciation part of for fruit. D, ya, this part is the sound, like the like a tooth. This is bird's feather or something. Anyway, this character means elegant. Yeah. And running style, I mean walking style, in between running and standing. This is standard script. You write, when you write horizontally, it goes from left to right. And if you write vertically, it will be from top down. Okay. And you write the walking style a little faster. Basically the same stroke order, but more connection. This part maybe, I will still write the same. Sometimes it become just something like that, yeah. And then this, just like that. So you just combine some of the strokes, like here. These two combined. That's the walking style. Then the cursive style, signature style, or grass style, same thing as cursive style. It changes the stroke, become one stroke. This become just a big, this become a kind of circle, half circle maybe. And this one become just three dots, and another kind of half circle, and then go up, and just go back. Yeah. This is about the same, but this part become different. Okay. Let me zoom in a little bit so you can see. I try to match the size of the seal, so the character is slightly bigger than the seal, not too much, because when you sign it, you can sign your just the given name, first name, if you want. So you can just write D, yeah, but Gaudia sounds like your last name, so it's more, you know, sounds like you. But I combined a little bit the different styles. You can certainly do that. Or you can write the whole. I think it's just easy to write all the strokes, but a little faster. So this one is a little tricky, because it kicks up, because I think it's nice to write this cursive style on this one. ya, let me write this character again. This is how it works. This is like that, just like a Z, and then a vertical stroke, and then kind of slant, but kicks back. So you have a teardrop shape. And here, land a teardrop. That's, yeah. Okay. Gao, first, last name comes first. Gao. You can write like that, just like for the square in the simplifying into this. And then D. Yeah. One more time. More cursive sound is around it. Okay, but this one, not much here is rounded. Okay. And next I will do the carving. As you see, the design is already approved. We did two designs. One is this one, just the name. The another one has an extra character for seal. It's a very common practice with the common character seal on the end of it. But she preferred the simplicity of this one. I agree. So we will do this one. The print is made on a laser jet with a carbon cartridge, not the inkjet. And then I use acetone with a nail polish remover to transfer the design. Evaporate in 10 seconds. That's a very clean copy, a flipped copy of the design. Now I will use a clamp to hold it. Do the carving. So in style or negative carving style, engraving style versus the relief carving or positive carving, which you cut out the background. This actually is more challenge, more artistic. You use the knife, the cutting tool, to create the calligraphy on the stone. So there's pressure variation, just like you write. So we call this iron brush. I hold the knife, the chisel with three fingers and my ring finger and small finger just to hold as a brick, you know, so I don't push without control. To rotate it because one side of the cut is smooth. My outside, yeah, outside, this side, and inside is chippy. So if you want a smooth line on both sides, you have to rotate. Oops. Building with a high tower. This is like a roof on top of it. So some just enough suggestion of the roof, but not like a picture, you know, but it was pictographic. This is called the lesser seal script, not a large seal script, which is more pictographic. This is a seal script in the Han Dynasty, scurrilized. Not so pictographic anymore. But still, you can tell that this is like the base foundation of the building, high rising building. High, Gao, and this is something like a door or window with an opening. It reads as mouth in Chinese characters. It could be part of the building in the beginning of this pictograph. Okay, then bamboo radical. We have some plant chipping, so try to create a natural feel, like bamboo leaves. between round and square. That's kind of shape I'm looking for. I try to vary the negative shape also inside. When you do things naturally, it's beautiful. To simulate the natural erosion or like an old seal. It's the taste of this form of art, we call it antiquarianism. It has influenced other form of art as well, like calligraphy and even painting. So many artists have seal engraving. Artist are also calligrapher and painters. And they introduced the taste of cutting, engraving into painting. So you use the soft brush as if you're using the knife, and vice versa. They have a mutual influence. Sister art. Some said this is the highest form of fine arts in Chinese art history, because it has all. It only have very limited space, but it has everything with visual art, dealing with the yin yang, negative positive, and line quality, stroke quality of calligraphy, space arrangement, everything. Okay, now we're working on the margin, which is very important to make it look old. Instead of a square, we make it into oval or a rounded corner with a shape resembling the very old old TV monitor in the 50s, maybe. That's the shape. So cut out the corner and then round up the margin. With the authenticity mark, they used to do this, just knocking out the chipping. It's not duplicable. I still think that's just a part of the design, chipping. It could be reproduced with digital. It could be faked on forgeries, but you know. The seal is no longer as authenticity proof for the original art, but it's still considered a chipping edge, a beautiful touch. So we just knock out some randomly. The stone seal resembles the bronze seal in Han Dynasty. Could be two thousand years old. The form is not changed that much. Material changed from bronze to stone in the Ming Dynasty. And the literary artists, the calligrapher and the painters started doing their own seals. Don't rely on the craftsmen, the artisans, you know, so it became a form of art. Become part of the painting. Calligraphy and the seal is an integral part of the painting. The seal you see on old paintings in the museums are mostly the, besides the original seal by the artist, it will be connoisseurs, collectors, or emperor's seal if they're national treasure in the palace. You know, they will put the library seals, studio seals on it as well. Okay. Ready to test. We'll just use this. Because this is a stone, it's hard, we need to put the rubber under it. Unlike the rubber stamp, you need to not to have a soft padding. You can use a book or magazine. We do sell this pad on our website. Okay, so I will sign on the left later, but now I just check visually which side is the upside. Okay. See how it goes. Wow. Very close. Okay, I just need to modify the margin a little bit. And a few more stroke. Okay, I think that's it. Let me try another. Oops, I didn't put the padding on it. Hey, we got soft felt. Let's see what happens. Yeah, you can still work with this felt. I got a mouse pad on it anyway. So I should put something not too soft. If you put soft, the margin tend to be bigger and the stroke may be thinner. But that's still nice, you know. Each print, a different material, a different paper, like a watercolor paper, would be different than on the rice paper. Okay, this is computer paper, so it's different. Okay, I'm going to use my collection book. I collect a copy of my seal. do it. Okay, there we go. Actually, we can use this stirrer to smooth it like that. After using, or before you use, you can stir it. This comes with the set, you can also buy individually. Blow a little moisture to make it less grain. It's a traditional trick. It's oil-based paste. Hold the paper before you lift it. Okay, that's my copy, and also I'll make some custom copies. And before the ink set, you can put a blotting paper, just protect it, don't block it, it will stain the other page maybe. It will dry overnight to touch, but if you smudge it, you can still smear it. Yeah. After using, you can clean it with a tissue, not too rough textured paper towel or things like that. Just a soft cotton tissue would be a cotton paper towel I'm using here. Okay, so on this card, let's see, it's a little slippery, don't move. You can wave a little bit because the ink is not flat surface, it's kind of like a relief. Okay. And you can clean. I usually clean it before I load so I know how much ink. I want to get rid of the residual in the stroke. Each stand, you can do that, and after using it, do that. Just use tissue. Okay. I'll sign on the left later. A little bit, but you know it's still nice with this thinner stroke. Paper is hard because it's slippery, too smooth. That's a good one. Okay, let me do the signature. I'll send this piece of paper to you, Teresa, so you can learn how to write. Okay, so this is the left. Left. So I usually mark the left as most serigraphic artists follow this rule, so you can tell which side is up easily. So this side indicates the left. When you hold the seal, the signature on the left, you can actually there's some mark on the top. Anyway, that helps you to identify which side is up. Let me take a picture. I'll do that later.